This week, Orbex, a UK launch provider, signs a deal with D-Orbit for their first mission. Second, we have a few updates from Skyroot Aerospace, an Indian space startup. Our third news item is about Gilmour Space, an Australian launch provider. And lastly, vast space updates, including a new launch date for Haven 1. Okay, let's get started. Orbex lands D-Orbit deal prior to first mission this year. The UK-based launch provider Orbex has signed a deal with D-Orbit. With this deal, D-Orbit will secure two launch opportunities on Orbex Prime, the company's micro-launcher, during the next 3 years. This positions D-Orbit to broaden its in-orbit services and support the growing satellite market. D-Orbit provides a range of on-orbit services, such as transporting satellites to their final positions, to testing payloads in space. Their satellite carriers also provide onboard data storage and advanced computing capacity while in orbit. Jonathan Firth, Chief Corporation Development Officer at D-Orbit, said, "We are very pleased to have signed this agreement with Orbex, further strengthening our commitment to the thriving UK space ecosystem. Orbex Prime's missions will provide valuable insights into the UK's orbital launch capabilities and expand our portfolio of orbital launch solutions. It's an exciting time to be part of the UK space industry, and we look forward to contributing to its continued growth and innovation." Orbex is nearing the end of the development of Orbex Prime, its low-carbon, high-performance micro-launcher. They will be launching from the Saxford Spaceport in Scotland with their own dedicated pad. Annual capacity will be up to 10 flights. Phil Chambers, the CEO at Orbex, said, "Our primary goal is to support the European space industry by offering flexible and sustainable satellite launch options direct from the UK. This customer agreement with D-Orbit is a testament to the technological progress we are making and proves the confidence that commercial space operators have in our plans. We look forward to working together." Okay, on to our second story this week. Skyroot Aerospace updates. Skyroot has been posting on social media recently. If you're not familiar with this company, they are an Indian space startup that are developing a range of rockets. They have already launched a suborbital rocket and are working on bigger orbital rockets. In a post on X, they say, "Testbed is buzzing. Our space mechanism and integration teams are running through a series of system checks, simulations, and analysis on our carbon composite payload fairing." In some other X posts, we can see structures that will be part of the Vikram 1 orbital rocket. The X post says, "From blueprint to reality, the carbon composite structures of Vikram 1, from interstages to payload fairing, now stand ready at our Max-Q campus. From design to manufacturing, these critical systems have been brought to life by a dedicated team on a mission." Skyroot are planning their first launch of the Vikram 1 orbital rocket in late 2025. Okay, on to our next story. Gilmour Space, why haven't they launched yet? Gilmour Space obtained a launch license in November 2024. It looked like they would be quickly able to launch after that, but it turns out it's not that simple. It was too close to Christmas for Gilmour to complete all the necessary tasks needed to prepare the vehicle, so they delayed the launch until mid-January. So, why haven't they launched so far? Well, even though they have all the needed licenses, they still need to coordinate with the Australian government and give them an advance warning. This appears to be what's causing the current delays. Specifically, the delay is with CASA, the Civil Aviation Safety Authority for Australia. Gilmour Space is waiting on a final permit, which the CEO of the company, Adam Gilmour, says is very close. Unfortunately, the long delays have resulted in a $20 million hit to the company, Adam Gilmour estimates. The inability to launch has also put the brakes on the next capital raising round. Rocket companies only earn money when launch vehicles fly. They need to raise venture capital funding to keep afloat. It's true they have diversified, so are not totally dependent on rocket launches, but their Bowen Spaceport and Gold Coast operations are expensive. The launch vehicle was moved to the pad in April 2024. Since that time, all the delays have been caused by lack of government permits and licenses. The company is expecting they will get the final sign-off next week, which means they can give the Australian Space Agency a 30-day mandatory notification and set a launch date. That puts the earliest launch date sometime in March 2025. Adam Gilmour says the company has plenty of cash, which gives them the time to get their first launch off the pad and, hopefully, into space. His biggest concern is that they are going to face the same long delays for the second and third vehicles. If so, he says, it will destroy the business. He said he would move the business to the US before that, It's just ridiculous how long it's taken to get the necessary paperwork approved, he said. Either the Australian government becomes more responsive to the space sector in Australia, or they are not going to have any space companies there. Instead, they will likely move to the US, which is much more friendly to them, and with the new administration, it should get even easier to do business. Gilmour Space has always known they would have to set up business in the US. They can't qualify for US government business unless at least 50% of the vehicles are built in the US. The question is, how quickly should they move? The Australian government doesn't appear very helpful to space companies, unlike the US. We'll keep you informed on Gilmour Space, and hopefully they get the permit needed to launch soon. Okay, on to our final story this week on Vast Space. Vast passes critical Haven 1 test milestone. Vast is making rapid progress in designing and engineering Haven 1, establishing themselves as a space station company. Their main aim is to secure the NASA Commercial LEO Destination Phase 2 contract, with NASA set to award grants in 2026. Vast needs to move fast as they plan on having an operational, crewed space station Haven 1 in orbit by the time NASA announces the winners. The idea of building and operating Haven 1 is to learn from it, gain operational experience, gain experience sending crews to and from a space station, and feed those insights into their Haven 2 design. This bigger space station is the design they will submit to NASA. No commercial space station operator will have the experience of Vast. That's of course if they manage to hit all these goals. More on how the timeline is changing later. At the end of January 2025, the Vast team began testing the Haven 1 primary structure at their purpose-built test facility. This marks the beginning of a full-scale vehicle test campaign for Vast. They began with pressurization tests to ensure the structure could withstand the internal pressures without leaking. The structure was pressurized up to 1.8 bar for a test duration of 5 hours. The leak rate remained within spec, and all the strain gauges stayed within acceptable ranges. The Haven 1 vehicle passed its proof test on the first attempt, a crucial milestone in the journey to launch. This structure was completed in 15 months from zero to a fully proof tested structure. Over the coming weeks, the company is planning qualification tests on applying simulated launch and on-orbit forces using hydraulic actuators. Now on to an update for the Haven 1 timeline. Vast, on their website, provided a table listing upcoming milestones and target dates. We can immediately see, looking at the table, that the launch has been pushed back from August 2025 to May 2026, with crew arriving at the station a month later for a two-week mission. We'll keep an eye on Vast Space and other commercial space station contenders, Axiom Space, Starlab, Sierra Space, and others. Okay, that's a wrap for this week. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.